Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir, and today we'll be learning some tips and tricks to how to optimize and speed up our Shopify website for better SEO, for better ranking, on for better sales. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. There's a small red color button which says subscriber, which is free of cost. You just need to subscribe and you'll be notified whenever I create new videos. So let's jump into optimizing our Shopify speed. So guys, first step of Shopify speed optimization is image optimization, in which I'll be showing you guys how you can optimize images of your store. So in order to find out which images need optimization, I would suggest you guys to go to gtmetrics.com and test your website in order to figure out which images you need to optimize. So ideally, all of the images in your Shopify store should be less than 500 kbps, and if it's bigger than that, then you should optimize the images which are more than 500 KB. So let's complete the analyzing of this test. So here's the report of our website. As you can see, we are already good in performance and structure. So I just wanted to show you guys as an example of how you can find out the heavier images in your store. So once the test is ready to review, you can click on waterfall tab here. And from waterfall tab, when you scroll down, you will see these columns, and here we have size. We can sort our files as per size. So click on that, and here we have the heavier files. So the most heaviest file we have on our website is 172 KB. So we don't need optimization in our case. But if you're seeing anything like more than 500 KB, which is an image file or 1 MB, then you should definitely optimize your image. And the question is now, how we'll optimize? So first, let's take a look at this page for an example. So we have our product page here, and as you can see, this image, it looks pretty cool, pretty neat. And when we click inspect on this image, so let's go to this image. So that's the code of this image. And when we hover over this file, we see that the image actual size is 1100 by 1650 pixel, but the rendered size is 713 and 1073 pixel. So the actual file size of the image is more than the rendered size. So ideally, we should have the same rendered size and the instinct size. So if you are looking to optimize, you should be downloading this image and resize image to its rendered size. So ideally, the rendered size and instinct size should be same. Now I'm gonna teach you a small trick on how you can change the size of your image and how you can reduce the size of your image in KB using Photoshop. So I'm gonna open up my Photoshop. So I'm using a little older version. I'm not an expert in Photoshop. I just use this for a little optimization of the images for the stores which we built. So our Photoshop is open, so I'm gonna open one of the image by clicking on file and then open. So let's take a look at this picture. So the picture size is around 11 MB, which is like 11,000 KB. Let's see how we can reduce the size of this image. So open that image in Photoshop. And now let's unlock the image first. And here we have image size. Now we should not have images more than 1500 pixels. So 15, if you're using product images or if you're using main slider images, it should not be more than 1500 width in pixels. So I'm gonna resize this to 1500 by 1000. Also, you can change the image size if you're seeing the instinct aspect ratio, instinct size is more than the rendered size. So in order to match the rendered size, you can simply resize your image from Photoshop and upload it again to your Shopify store. So let's click OK, and then To reduce the image file size in KB, just click on File and then Save for Web. So if you're using a latest version of Photoshop, you should see an option here, Export, and then there will be an option called Save for Web. Find out this option and click on that. And here we have, as you can see now, this image is around 2.6 MB. Now this is 2.6 MB just because it's PNG. Now we will convert it to JPEG for reducing size a bit more. So I'm going to convert it to JPEG and then make sure that the progressive is checkmarked. Now as you can see, the image is now 888 KB. So on top we have our original image and below we have the optimized version. Now we can further reduce the quality and zoom into the image to make sure the pixels of the images are not burned. So that's the original file and that's our optimized version. Now I'm going to reduce quality a bit. And then we think 72 is enough. And as you can see now, it's 289 KB file size. Okay, now hit save. Now let's save the image on our desktop. And we are done with the optimization. Now guys, second thing what we can do in order to optimize our Shopify store is lazy load. In other words, we also called it differ off-screen images. So the images will only be displayed when you'll actually scroll to those images. So it will only be loaded when you, if you have an image on the bottom of your home page, and it will not be loaded until and unless you scroll down to the bottom of your home page. So that's what is called lazy load, and I'm gonna show you how to implement that using lazy sizes. So that's the library which we'll be using to implement lazy load in our Shopify store. I'll put the link in the video description so you guys can easily download it. So that's the library which we'll be using. So in order to implement that, go to the backend of your Shopify store. And from there, click on online store. And from online store, go to actions and then click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to back up your theme by duplicating it. So if you mess up anything, you can easily revert it back. Now click on edit code. And then go to assets and click on add a new asset. So here we will be uploading the JS library which we downloaded from here. So I have it already downloaded, which I'm going to upload. So that's the lazy sizes library which we are implementing in order to add lazy load in our Shopify store images. So upload it. And then after uploading it, go to theme.liquid file. And in theme.liquid under head, we'll be adding a code. So here's the code which I'll be adding in order to implement the lazy load. Don't worry about the code. You'll find it in the YouTube video description. So don't need to worry about that. Just copy the code and paste it below header. So I'm going to add it on line number 10. Okay, now hit save. And now all you need to do is just add in the class is equal to lazy load. In order to add in lazy load functionality in any of the Shopify image. So for example, if I go to my customize section. So that's the home page. And if I scroll down to the bottom, I have this custom liquid where I have added this image. So that's a really heavy image and that's the code for this image. Now all I need to do is add in class is equal to lazy load and it's safe. So that's how we can implement lazy load functionality in our Shopify store, which will help you speed up your Shopify store. So guys, third trick which we'll be implementing in our Shopify in order to speed up our Shopify store is reducing the usage of our apps. So if you're using a lot of apps on your store, it will definitely add an external resources to your Shopify backend, and it will slow down your Shopify store. And even if you delete some of them after later on, it will still leave some of the scripts in your theme.liquid file. So in order to remove those extra snippets, what you're gonna do is go to your theme.liquid file. So I'm gonna show you here right now. So I have one of theme, which is from my client store. That's the theme which I was supposed to optimize. And if we go to theme.liquid file of that theme, okay, I'm gonna click on edit code for that. Okay, so that's our theme code. And if we go to theme.liquid file and search for include, we will see that we can, so it's an offer. You might find an app by the name of offer or something like UFE offer. Or if I search more, we have another app which is called Gobo Filter Action. So these are the apps. When you install these apps, these codes get added in your theme.liquid file, and when you delete these apps, the code don't get deleted and still pull up the external files, external JS file and external resources, which are not supposed to load in your Shopify store, and which is making your store heavier to load. So I suggest reduce the usage of Shopify apps and try to find a solution by liquid coding CSS or JavaScript, and not to use apps for every small functionality or small reason. So that's it for the video, guys. I hope you guys liked it. This will definitely help you speed up your Shopify store. If you're having any issues implementing the lazy load, or if you're having any issues understanding what I taught you guys in this video, feel free to comment on the video and let me know what you would like to learn more in Shopify, so I can create more valuable content for you guys. Until next video, have a great day.